Please listen. This one technique, this one technique can give you whatever you want and lead you to the space of not wanting anything. Enlightenment itself. Please listen. Mahadeva, Shiva, directly initiates this technique to Parvati. This one technique can give you health, wealth, happy relationships, whatever miracles you want in your life, and ultimately enlightenment itself. Please understand, I am not lying. I am not giving you false hope. I am not giving you too much of promises. I am stating the straight fact, straight truth to you. Mahadeva himself, Shiva himself, gives this technique to Parvati in Shivahama. Shivahama is a large literature. Techniques Mahadeva himself taught to Devi Parvati. It is Mahadeva's words, but I also experienced it. So I also stand for this technique and the truth revealed in this technique. This is from Shivahama, the portion called Shivagnanopanishad, Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, 94th verse, 22nd technique. Mahadeva is beautifully describing. I'll explain this technique and then give you exact procedure how to do it. Please listen carefully. Chittatyantaha kritir nasti mamantar bhavayet iti vigalpanam abhavena vigalpair uchito bhavet. It's direct Mahadeva's words. I'll read out the translation. Consciously feel within the mind stuff of past memories of incompletion with its activities as mind, intellect and ego are not existing in me. By contemplating this way in your inner space, disidentify from the past impressions and memories of incompletion. Put your active attention at the space of the past happening. Relive these imagined impressions and memories of incompletion. Then the mind stuff, having fully ceased from its present characteristics of forming thought patterns and cognitions, is complete. Thus you become complete and achieve the original space of complete completion. Now, I'll give you exact method. I've read out the original verse and translation. Just to tell you, it is not my discovery. The technique is from the original Vedic tradition. I am only contributing the permutation combination, means how to do it. Only that is my contribution. But the original knowledge is from Vedic tradition. I'll give you an example of incompletion. For example, actually, this is one of the main example I use, because I directly saw one person suffering with this problem. One person, when he was a kid, 7 or 8 years old, was walking in the beach with the father. He saw a few fishermen fighting with each other. The fight ended in murder. One fisherman got killed. Fisherman got killed. One person was killed. Naturally, the kid ran away from the scene. When he met me, he was at least 40. He says, even now I can't go to beach. Even if I crash beach in the car, I'll have that same palpitation, fear, same engrams coming up. Understand this situation. When I narrated this situation, how many of you feel you also have like this some patterns? Raise your hand. That's all. Now listen. The situation, the incident which happened, the child is walking and he is seeing 3-4 fishermen, few of them fighting with each other. One got murdered. That situation, that is the root incident. When he saw that, the powerlessness he experienced, that fear he experienced, the child was not able to handle that situation. So naturally, he suppresses and runs away. Whatever was happening in him, the fear or powerlessness, even that feeling, maybe this will be done to me also. All that feeling, he just suppressed and ran away from the situation. Understand? Whenever powerlessness is suppressed, along with that suppression, all the emotions associated in that situation, powerlessness means pain, suffering, fear, so many things, guilt connected to it, that I am not able to do anything in this situation. So many things associated with it, all that also gets suppressed. And as long as that suppression exists, this pattern will continue. Whenever he goes to beach, he will go through the same moments, experience which he suppressed first time. For example, the suppressed powerlessness acts like a ground, and the pattern is a tree. I'll try to draw a tree. I don't know whether it looks like a tree, but imagine it's a tree. The suppressed emotions, powerlessness, fear, anger, inability to help, guilt, resentment, whatever the child would have gone through at that situation, at the age of 7, when the incident happened, all that suppression forms like a solid ground for this incompletion pattern, tree to stand. See, this is the suppressed emotions. Suppressed emotions and powerlessness. And this tree is the incompletion pattern. Every time it repeats itself, whenever you go to the beach, the experience repeating itself, the fear repeating itself, that attack, panic attack happening, that is the incompletion patterns. Listen, because of this ground, this tree is standing. If you relive that incident, listen here, later on you can pen down, please listen. if you relive that incident, not remember, there's a big difference between remembering and reliving. Remembering means, now that man, when I met him, he was 40. Being a 40-year-old person and thinking what happened at the age of 7 is remembering. But forgetting you are 40, becoming that 7-year-old, that same intelligence, same space, same mood, same identity, even the idea about me, I, which you had at that same time. See, that person, to relive, has to become that 7-year-old identity. And if he relives, if you relive, the suppressed emotions, powerlessness will break, it will open up, it will leave your system. Automatically, this incompletion pattern tree will not have place for its roots, it will fall off. Listen, this is the science of completion. All suppressed emotions, powerlessness, difficulties, guilt, resentment, during the root incident, keeps the incompletion pattern alive. If you relive that root incident, not remember. I am not asking you to remember. Remembering is superficial. Reliving means forgetting your present age, everything, dump it, go back to that age when that incident happened. Same mind, same energy, same consciousness, same intelligence, same identity. Become that, decide to become that. And start reliving the incident. Suddenly you will see all that pain, suffocation, you go through everything once more, but this time completely. You will allow that to leave your nervous system. You will allow that to melt down through your nervous system. You will allow that to cleanse your nervous system. With this cleansing, with this releasing, the panic attacks regularly you go through, incompletion pattern attack which you go through regularly will not be there, it will just collapse. The incompletion tree, incompletion patterns tree will just collapse because the ground is gone. The tree is not able to have the right ground. When the ground is taken away, naturally the tree collapses. This is the science of reliving. Please understand. Whenever I ask you to relive, don't judge that incident with your present knowledge. No, I am not asking you to reconcile. No, completion is not reconciliation, it is not remembering, it is reliving. How many ever time you try to reconcile, you will never be able to forgive yourself, some people in your life for what has happened. So reconciling is not what I am asking you to do. Relive, not only you will forgive, you will forget them. I don't even ask you to forgive, don't forgive. You will simply forget them. You will simply forget them. I tell you, when you are able to forget them, they will have their karma back. Understand? When you are able to forget them, they will have their karma back. I never forgave anybody. And I never cursed anybody. I just know how to forget. They are having their karma back. Understand? So be very clear. Incompletions create emotional knots. I tell you, if you are holding on to that hatred, grudge, fear, unable to forgive yourself and others, you are only going to suffer. It's like you drink poison and you expect your enemy to die. No, that's foolishness. I never get agitated. I just make them get agitated. I just agitate them and leave it. Forget, you will be living in your space. They will only be getting agitated, whoever has attacked you or tortured you. So listen, completion is not reconciliation. Completion is not remembering. Completion is reliving. All of you are clear? Now, you have written so many of your fears and the incidents when the fears started. Pick up one by one the incident. Relive means forget your present age, identity, personality, drop everything. Go back to that same age and that same identity, that same mental setup. As much as you can remember that, become that. And try to relive that incident, how it happened, step by step. Slow motion flashback. Flashback in slow motion. Relive at least 5 times. Relive at least 5 times. You will see so much of suffocation, pain, resentment, guilt, anger, feeling tortured, everything will open up. Everything will leave your system. The more and more this powerlessness leaves your system, more you will be blissful. More you will be complete. Of course, I am here. I'll also support you. I'll do my job, my jadu, so don't worry. And I'll see to it you are complete. With Mahadeva's grace, as a living representative of his energy, I bless you all. Let you all achieve complete completion, complete Puranatva in your life. Let's start the process slowly, very slowly. You can open your eyes. How many of you already feel the completion is working for you? You are feeling relieved with many of the stress and fears. Raise your hand. Good. Even if it doesn't click, catch in the first session, don't worry. In the next deeper process, you will catch it. It is one of the alpha to omega technique. From a beginner to the professional seeker, this is the best technique. If you are new to spirituality, or you are in spirituality for last 35 years, 50 years, this is the technique.